G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And this is part four in the series on calculating wall bracing. And now we're going to start looking at designing the bracing systems. And the first thing we're going to look at as far as that's concerned is what we call nominal bracing. Okay, so just to recap, so previously we worked out the pressure that is going to be applied to our wall. And we know that wind direction one had an area elevation of 43.553 square meters, which gave us a total racking force of 47.908 kilonewtons. Okay, that's the force that's going to act on that wall. And for wind direction 2, we had 20.258 kilonewtons acting in wind direction 2. So now we're going to look at actually designing the bracing to resist that force. And the first thing we have to consider is what we call nominal bracing. Okay, so nominal bracing is basically made up of what our internal lining is. So if we're using gyprock or villa board or any type of lining boards, our internal lining makes up our nominal bracing. So a couple of rules around that. We can only use nominal bracing to resist 50% of the total racking force in any direction. And if there's a panel size that's less than 450 mil, we can't consider it. Okay, so if you've got a section of wall that's less than 450 mil long, you can't include that in your calculations. Okay, and it should be evenly distributed throughout the building. Okay, otherwise that should be pretty normal. Okay, so the tables in the timber framing code say that the capacity of nominal wall bracing for single-sided walls is 0.45 kilonewtons per meter, and for walls sheeted on both sides, it's 0.75 kilonewtons per meter. So basically what we have to do is work out the length of those walls in the building, and then times it by the bracing capacity. That will give us how much resistance the nominal bracing is going to give us. So let's do that with our example house. So wind direction one is down the bottom here. The wind's blowing against the long side of the house. So that all the walls at 90 degrees to the wind direction, all right, will be resisting that. So 90 degrees, or the same direction as the actual wind direction, I guess. They're the walls that are gonna actually resist it, because the wind will blow against this wall, and these walls will help resist the load, if you know what I mean. So the first one we're going to look at is walls with one side sheeted only. So they are your external walls, because in this case there's a cavity and then the brickwork. Okay, so I've got the two external walls, and then I've got these two ones here near the door. So we just work out the length of those walls. So wall one, which is starting on the left-hand side, the long wall, 7 meters long. Wall two, which is next to the door, it's 1.1 meters long. Wall three, 1.1, and wall four, 7 meters long. So we just add them up. Gives me a total length of 16.2 meters. And we times that by our bracing capacity per meter, which was 0.45 for single-sided walls. So that gives us a total bracing capacity of 7.425 kilonewtons for the single-sided walls. So now we have to do the double-sided walls. So here we've got our double-sided walls highlighted. So all these walls on this side of the building are pretty much the same length, so I'm just going to work them out all together. Okay, so four walls at 2.5 meters long there. Then we've got this wall here, so one wall at 3.5 meters long there. And then these two, so two walls at 2.4 meters long gives us 4.8. So again, times, we have 4 by 2.5 gives you 10, 1 by 3.5 gives you 3.5, 2 by 2.4 gives you 4.8, total length of 18.3 meters, 18.3 times our bracing capacity for double-sided walls, or two sides, 0.75 gives us 13.725 kilonewtons. So we add those two amounts together, we get a total resistance from our nominal bracing in wind direction one of 21.150 kilonewtons. So we can go back over. So we've worked out our nominal bracing of 21.150. We required 47.908 kilonewtons. So we minus the 21. It's less than half, so we don't have to worry about the 50% rule. So we still require 26.758 kilonewtons of resistance in wind direction 1. All right, so that's wind direction 1 done. In the next video, I'll have a look at wind direction 2.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.